Hi everyone! Today I'm doing a project for AB Studio by Aga Baraniak, and those are some products from AB Studio I'm gonna be using. And I'm working in my old book. And the first thing to do is to, of course, treat the page so there is no seepage. And this time I'm using a white gesso and I'm spreading it unevenly with the brush. I'm gonna start by stamping, and I'm using a black jet archival ink, and the stamp you see me using right now, it's a stamp designed by my lovely talented friends Aditi and Sunila Mahajan, and it comes from a Crafty Scrappers, and I'm using also Kaiser Craft stamp and Paper Artsy stamp, and basically I'm stamping randomly like I usually do. And I'm working as usually with archival ink, which I really love. This is another stamp. I love this kind of doodling writing. I'm not sure what is it exactly. It comes from Joy Stamp. It's a wild African. And I want to apologize you all. I am a little out of sorts. I was sick. All my family was sick this week. So I'm all over the place and I'm not speaking, normally I'm not speaking very well and today it's gonna be just probably a disaster. I was thinking to maybe just do writing, but I actually was too lazy to do the writing, to do the subtitles, so I decided to speak instead. I'm using now a stencil designed by Aga Baraniak, AB Studio. It's a stencil number 14. And I'm using a Crystal Effect Mortar. It's a paste designed by or made by a Renaissance. It's a Polish company, as far as I know. And this paste, well, I use it with this stencil, but actually it's very hard to spread it as it has crystals in it. And you have to leave it to dry, to air dry. So it takes time as well. So then at the end I just spread it with my spatula on the edges of the book. And the paste is dry, I left it overnight, and I'm starting to add some coloring. I'll be using, as always, Lindy's Gang sprays. I'll try to use sprays which are kind of darkish in color. I want to make a kind of blunt page if it's possible to say that, and so I'm starting with Gag Me with a Spoon Gray, and then I'm gonna be using some black. And you may think that with black, for example, the colors are gonna be quite strong, but this is not gonna be the case because I'm using a lot of water and I'm diluting the colors a lot, and that's actually which is very nice also about Lindy's. You can dilute the colors and you'll see they are completely, you can achieve completely different effects. So okay, I'm gonna leave it at that because I'm rambling and I am completely all over the place. And just for those who don't know it yet, if you need a list of products I used in this video, you will find it in the description box below or on my blog. And if you have any questions, if I didn't explain something quite clearly, please let me know in the comments and I will get back to you. and I am back, and I'm gonna be doing some distress stamping. That's how I call it anyway. I'm using a Lindy's Magical Shaker and I'm diluting it with water. And this one is a stamp, a really nice stamp from Stamperia. I really like it. It's a crackle stamp. I don't even put it on the acrylic block because it's quite heavy, quite flat. It doesn't bend too much, so you can actually put it like that on the page. And I'm using the Magical with the stamp, and like that I have this distressed look. You can see here in the right hand corner a little bit of the stamping. And again, I'm gonna be using AB Studio papers. This is from collection Be Gentle. Well, not again, I am showing you this paper again, but for the first time I'm showing you the die cut. Yes, I think die cut. Well, which I cut actually not with a machine but with the scissors. And I'm placing it onto the page with a tacky glue. And I don't know if you've seen me, I use the ruler to make the crease in the middle. So then when you close and open the art journal, the crease doesn't, the paper you glued, the die cut, is not getting broken. And this is my stones, which I found at the beach during my holidays, and I brought, and this is like a heavyweight thing to me. And I was just putting a little bit of lace in the corners, and again using AB Studio papers to add some more leaves. Now I'm gonna be using some cogs from Snip Art, but I don't really know why, because it's the page is more shabby chic, I think, and I decided to add some steampunk elements, but why not? I kind of thought that they will go well together. And I'm choosing the cogs. This is collection Industrial Factory, and I'm gonna be embossing them with, guess what, this is obviously black embossing powder by Lindy's. It's completely unreadable on the video like that, but well, believe me, it's that. And I embossed it with a wow embossing pad, and but dry it with my heat gun as always, and place it with a tacky glue. And now I'm using a Stabilo all Marxol, I think it's called, and I'm doing some shading. This pencil is really great because you can dilute it with water and it sticks to almost all surfaces, porous and non-porous, so you can really work your magic with it. And as you can see, I'm always also doing borders. And for some splatter, I'm using water-soluble oil pastels by Prima. And they give me always this tiny splatter, which I cannot somehow achieve with the brush and either acrylic or mists. So I use always this one for a tiny splatter. And I decided to also darken the edges of the journal. And I'm using the same oil pastel. And for the sentiment, I'm using a few sentences from 7Dot Studio word stickers. I think that's all of them comes from Paint Chips collection. And this is Dovecraft 3D enamel paint. And I'm adding some black dots here and there. And if I am not mistaken, as I've done this project a little bit earlier, this is almost the end. Apart from, yes, one addition, well, two additions. I add some gesso on the cogs, and now I am also adding a little bit of Finabar Opal Magic Wax Turquoise Satin, and also a little bit on the edges to make this shine, which is not really clearly visible on the photos, but it's there. So this is my finished project for AB Studio. I hope you enjoy it despite me being not very enthusiastic today. Okay, I'm adding splatter. This is amazing. Always splatter. I think I don't do art journal pages without the splatter, but everybody has their own quirks, and this is obviously mine. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. You can share it with your friends, and if you can subscribe to my channel, that would be really great. And if you have any questions, please give me or write me a comment. And for the products, see the box below. Okay, have a nice day. Bye bye.